Welcome to the Elder Abyss Show. For talking videos, it's the place to go. Game tips, rants, tactics, and more. What you'll find here, you can never be sure.
Hey guys, welcome to the show. In this episode, we are featuring a little bit of Homefront for your viewing pleasure. It's a little bit of a different game style and gameplay than the last Homefront video I brought to you guys. The last one being pretty much infantry only. I think that map is actually limited to infantry only, where you can have a few drones or that kind of thing. But that's about it. I believe that one was called Suburbs. This one is the Green Zone, I believe. Pretty sure name of it, as I toast that dude with the RPG. So we've got Green Zone here. I like this map. There's, for the most part, most of the maps that I've come into contact with, you know, for this game, I'm enjoying. There's one or two that's kind of so-so, questionable. But the maps are seem to be really well done. They're really detailed. They're really intricate. I like them. I think they've done a good job. Every building or place or little area on these maps has its own personality. There's not a lot of redundant materials for the most part. So on this map though, this map, pretty much every time that I play it, it turns into more of a vehicle map, I guess you could say. It's just so damn tempting to get in the Humvee and drive around the roads. Thanks. And to be honest, I've done it myself, and it is quite fun. The only drawback, really, to vehicles, like the Humvee, the APC, and things, is if you purchase them and you're going to drive them, you need a gunner. And unfortunately, right now, there are some severe server issues with this game. And just to take a sidebar on that note, don't we get tired of that? Every multiplayer, major multiplayer title seems to have server issues, matchmaking issues, some kind of garbage issues we see in every one of them on release, and it always takes them a few weeks to a month or so to get it straightened out. I'm tired of it already. Figure out a formula, make it work, right? Enough of that. As right there, I should have dropped down and just waited on that guy instead of pushing in there with that saw. Because I got too close, his gun had the advantage in that range, and I paid the price. But what I'm bringing you, if I can actually get around to getting it out, is some gameplay where you're dealing with vehicles. I've been watching a little bit of Homefront footage, and I've seen quite a bit of gameplay getting posted up, and that is using vehicles to get monolithic scores. And yes, that can be done. And it reminds me of when Black Ops first landed and the rage of the day was the chopper gunners and the big beastly scores. To me, you know, that's okay to watch, and nothing against that. There's not a problem with it, but it's not my particular cup of tea. As far as what the type of content I like to bring you, I like to bring you stuff where at least some point in the video I might be able to help you out with something. And in this video, what I'm trying to kind of share with you guys is how I approach dealing with vehicles, so that you can hopefully prevent someone else from pulling the big monolithic vehicle score on you. So on this match, what I'm running the Saul, the M249 with the hollow. Love that gun with the hollow scope, the hollow sights. I'm really having a good time with that gun right now. I've got the EMP grenade for vehicles. At if you hit a vehicle with that, it kind of disables it for a little bit of short period of time. The actual time frame varies depending on what specs the vehicle has equipped, or the person that spawned it or driving or whatever. Not sure how that works. The sniper hiding in that nest up there. I seen you. And of course the RPG. Can't get enough of the RPG. I really like the RPG in this game. And I've also got the Hellfire. Those are my two purchase slots. And I know there's a Humvee cruising around back there. I heard him. I see him on the mini-map. He's back behind one of those buildings. So that's been kind of my job, if you've probably already noticed, is I'm keeping those Humvees down with my RPG. Just like that. And somebody threw an EMP grenade. That's what went off there with that flash. He was just a little late to the party. Already had the guy smoking in cinders by the time the EMP got thrown, I think. And there went one of the little drones. Those things are badass. But, oh, here's my sniper friend. He's still in that nest. And yet another use for the RPG. Hey, you know he's been up there for a while because I've seen him when I was around the other corner. He's probably thinking he had a nice little pattern figured out to stay alive. Not so, son. Now, right there, I believe I got spotted. You see, we've got a drone up in the air doing their spots. They had a drone up in the air spotting for them. And one thing I like about this game is it actually tells you when you're spotted. You'll see it come up in that upper left-hand corner, letting you know that you're spotted. And there's that enemy drone that was spotting me. Take him out. Drone patrol is part of another thing I like to do because I don't like to be spotted. I like my anonymity, and spotting it, well, it takes it away from me. And also, like I was saying earlier, I really like the SAW, so I tend to run it. And I've found that the LMGs are very well suited for dealing with drones, both the ground and the air drones. You know, one, you've got so much ammo in them. Clip or magazine. Oh! A twofer on a Humver Hellfire and a twofer Free Fire Hellfire. That's a lot of words there. But two missiles, four kills. I love that. And we're going to take another strike. Got one shot in the tank. Next shot is a complete fail. So they've got a tank up there now. Well, that's what I'm after. I got one Hellfire in him. The tanks are reasonably tough. And check this guy out. He's just standing here. He's holding a control for a drone. Man, if you're going to deploy your drone, at least grab some cover, go prone. You're just asking for a world of pain standing out in the middle like that. So I got another rocket in the tank, and another rocket, and he blows the living daylights out of me and drone boy standing there. Almost had the tank. If I'd have landed that second Hellfire missile, I would have had him there because he was just one more rocket away from going down, and somebody cleaned him up, which kind of brings me to one of my gripes as I try and deal with another drone up in the air. One of my gripes about this game, especially when you're dealing with the vehicles, or particularly when you're dealing with the vehicles like we just saw, there doesn't seem to be any assists or partial credit type score for that, at least not that I've ever seen come up. On that tank, I hit it with a Hellfire, two RPGs. One more RPG finishes it off, and whoever got that got the points for it, and I got nothing. Oh, damn, that is just beautiful. Me blowing up the Humvee, not the points issue I was just talking about. But I would like to see that addressed, but in all fairness, they've got some more serious issues they need to focus on before they get to something like that. So I will forgive for now that being overlooked, such that hopefully I could actually get into a server with my friends, because with the server issues going on right now, it's not that big of an issue to join if you're just by yourself. But if you try to party up with your friends, or if you try to join on one of your friends, it goes to shit quick, and it gets really aggravating. It jams it up in such a way that most times you have to actually dashboard the game and reboot the game in order just to connect by yourself, which is frustrating to say the least. And I'm really, according to the update on their site, they're aware of that and they're working on it, and that patch for it should be coming soon. They've already got two patches planned. One of them is headed for certification now. The next one is headed for certification as soon as the first one gets out. So probably looking 1 to 2 weeks before these major issues get completely worked out in some satisfactory manner. But that's where it's at on the server issues. But where was I on the game? This guy just got shot. In the corner. And I think, yep, there's another guy hiding in the corner on me. Uncool, but okay. So as I've rambled on here, I hope that I have demonstrated in some capability in the gameplay of a good technique for dealing with particularly ground vehicles. I think this is a complete fail of the lights that I see. No, this is my suppressing. So there's a guy shooting out of the gazebo down there. He dropped one dude. I really didn't have any expectations of killing him with that fire. I just wanted to get him to back up so I can make it around the corner without getting killed myself. I'm going now to have a short talk, if you will, with that gentleman in the gazebo. Turns out he don't got much to say. Oh. But as far as dealing with those ground vehicles, I hope maybe I gave you some idea, especially if you don't own the game, of how some of these ground vehicles play out, particularly the Humvees and that one sample of the tank we had. There's a couple of other ground vehicles, the APC and a couple of things, I think. There's also a couple of helicopters. So, I mean, the vehicles are here. They are fun to play with. Especially the ground vehicles. Oh, as I pop another Humvee. I am the smiter of all Humvee. What I was going to say is most of the ground vehicles are better if you can get at least one other person in you. That didn't come out right. In the vehicle with you. Like the Humvee and the APCs and your drivers and gunners. And like I said, it's just a little hard to do. You have to kind of hang out and blow your horn and hope somebody jumps in. I've seen some guys that will take the Humvees and drive them and then switch seats and shoot. And, you know, I can understand the frustration if you buy a Humvee and you want to do that. And it's hard to get people in your vehicle when you want them, that you might be inclined to do that. But you are RPG bait if you do that. Just a heads up on that, guys. Be careful if you're using that tactic, because there's going to be a dude like me somewhere that always has an RPG handy with a grin on his face waiting for you. But that wraps us up pretty close to the end of the episode. I think that tops me out with 25 and 6. Thanks, guys. Later.
We're all just gamers growing old.